For the 20th consecutive year, ABC Sports presents the Pro Bowlers Tour. Today, the championship finals of the $100,000 Fairlanes Open as these five bowlers compete for the top prize. In fifth place from Chicago, Illinois, his first year on the PBA Tour, Mark Fahy. In fourth place from Van Nuys, California, consistent money winner on the tour since 1973, Jay Robinson. In third place from Falls Church, Virginia, competing in his first tournament this year, Steve Sipe. In second place from Kingsport, Tennessee, winner of four PBA career titles, Steve Martin. And our leader from Tucson, Arizona, seeking his first title. In 1981, the current PBA Player of the Year, Wayne Webb. Baltimore, situated near the Chesapeake Bay, is a growing metropolis of over 1 million people. It is a city rich in history, but has kept up with modern expansion as well. Since 1955, the Inner Harbor area has been transformed into a marketplace, which has attracted millions of visitors every year. And when in Maryland, you never pass up oysters or the many crab dishes. And with temperatures in the 70s, spring has arrived in this great city. And we're live inside the Fairlanes Bowling Center, the site today for the championship finals of the $100,000 Fairlanes Open. And hello again, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Chris Schenkel, delighted to be back in Baltimore, where I've spent a lot of time over the years. These fans really make whoopee. You'll hear them this afternoon. Believe me. This is the 11th Fairlanes Open consecutively that we have televised. It's the first time in this house, the Woodlawn. It's a beautiful bowling establishment. And for the first time in 13 weeks, on our show, we do not have Earl Anthony, we don't have Marshall Holdman, or we don't have Mark Roth. We have a tremendously interesting field. We have a local pro, we have a rookie, we have two consistent winners. We have last year's bowler of the year. Last year's champion in the Fairlanes Open was a young man from St. Louis, our colleague Nelson Burton Jr., so let's join him right now. Bo, go get him.
Thank you, Chris. I was a bit disappointed not defending my title, but we really ended up with a great group of players here today. We have two established stars at the top and some rookies and newcomers in the middle of the field. Now, so far through the season this year, the averages on the Pro Bowlers Tour are very comparable with the 1980 averages, right around 214 for the number five spot. But recently, we've seen some low scores in our telecast. In fact, a 192.8 average over the last 2 weeks. Now, there's a number of reasons why the scores can be either high or low on a telecast. Number one, the pressure of the players naturally going on. Number two, the PBA themselves maintains the lanes. They try to put a fair and equitable condition out for everybody out there so that accuracy and shot making brings the players to the top. But the third and most important reason is the pair of lanes themselves. By the luck of the draw, we might catch a real high scoring pair or maybe one of the more difficult pairs in a house, and that's determined a little bit by the track, the worn area, the humidity in the building, and even the pin spotting. So today, we can look for some tremendous scores because we have a pair of lanes that has yielded a 230 or better average for the top five players. Now, the man who is more qualified than anyone to talk about the TV pair is our tournament leader, Wayne Webb. Wayne, you've had great success last year, Bowler of the Year, defending Firestone champion, and you're really improving so far this year.
Well, I think the lanes are going to really be nice, and everyone should bowl real good today.
Well, Wayne, as you said, the TV pair is a high-scoring pair. Everybody averaged 230. What do you think the score to win will be?
I don't know. I think the final game is, I think it's going to take 250 or 240 to win.
Chris, we haven't seen any big games, but the top players predict some big scores today on the championship pair.
All right. Thank you very much, Bo. And ladies and gentlemen, here in the Fairlanes Open, we have a total purse of $100,000. And the winner today on our live telecast will receive $13,000. Runner-up, $7,500, $5,500, $45,000, and $4,000. So we invite you to stay tuned now for our first match, head-to-head, live coverage as rookie Mark Fahy of Chicago meets two-time winner Jay Robinson of California. Stay tuned.
Hey there, Tex. What in the blazes is that thing?
This is one of them new small models.
Ride good?
Good. Ride's great. Got me some Monroe-matic shocks. Little big shocks from Monroe.
Little big shocks?
Yep. Best ride I ever had.
Of course. Them's Monroe's.
Darn tootin' Monroe little big shocks. Even fits imports.
Imports? What's imports?
Small car. America rides Monroe.
When our band's cooking, the music smokes. But not me, because like a lot of my friends, right, I use Skoal smokeless tobacco. I just take a pinch of that good-tasting wintergreen-flavored Skoal between my cheek and gum, and it gives me real tobacco pleasure without ever lighting up. So when you want something that smokes, listen to the Charlie Daniels Band. But when you want real tobacco enjoyment without smoking, try Skoal. A pinch is all it takes. Thank you. We appreciate it.
You're about to see Ford pickups make six-cylinder EPA fuel economy history. For 1981, Ford breaks this mileage barrier. Yes, only Ford has MPG this high with a 2,500-pound payload. Here's another breakthrough. The first and only automatic overdrive option in any eight-cylinder truck. When your speed reaches about 40, it automatically shifts into overdrive and your engine runs slower. Only Ford has V8 automatic overdrive. For 1981, Ford pickups make one breakthrough after another. They're built Ford tough.
In our first match today, big, huge, 23-year-old on the right, Mark Fahy of Chicago, the rookie, will go against Jay Robinson. This is our live coverage, a capacity crowd here, outdoors, a spring-like day, 218-pounder shooting first on the left lane. Well, almost made it, Bill.
Well, Chris, the championship pair, 17-18 here at Fairlane's Woodlawn, is, as we said, one of the highest scoring pairs in the house. And one of the reasons being is that the track is very playable for the right-handed players. To keep it between the second and third arrow, they should be around the pocket.
And the professional, who has bowled in only 10 tournaments, covers the two-pin very nicely in the first frame, marking with a spare. And, of course, those of you that have watched our telecast over the years, no, Jay Robinson. He's 37 years old. Been a PBA member for 14 years. Has won two titles. 5'10", 170 pounds. Nearly lost it in the channel. And, of course, he's going to have a problem with the 2-8-10.
Chris, we said the pair is equitable, and we meant that you could play almost anywhere, but Jay Robinson surprised all of us by moving to the extreme outside line on his first shot in the telecast and left the 2-8-10.
Moving to the left of center, Robinson to the line. Over the years, Jay has been very consistent, yet he's only won two tournaments. We asked him why.
Even though I've only won two titles on the tour, I think that the reason I haven't won more is my bowling ball. It's not as devastating as some of the boys that hook it. I'm more of a consistent shot maker instead of a strong ball.
All right. 37-year-old Jay Robinson. Losing 12 feet of the approach as he goes to the line. And the first strike of the first match here in Baltimore. Land of the Colts and the Orioles, crab cakes, oysters, Bo.
Well, everybody's had a good time, and they love the seafood out here on the East Coast.
Crossing over, Mark Fahy, leaving the 2-6-9. Young man that was a Golden Gloves heavyweight champion in Chicago, representing the YMCA, decided that his hands were too brittle for boxing and came out on the tour. Well, he has an open frame coming in the second frame. We asked him the difference between being on the Rabbit Squad and being seated.
Thursday.
Well, on the Rabbits, I bowl well because I feel there's less competition. And when I come back on Wednesday and Thursday, I'm surrounded by the best seated bowlers, and I get a little tensed up.
Chris, the unseated players have to qualify on Monday to get the main portion of the tournament on Wednesday.
And Mark liked that. That'll loosen him up, take out any jitters that he might have because he had an open frame. But this strike came in the third, and now Jay Robinson, the veteran, can double, and it would increase his lead to 13.
We said at the top of the telecast that we felt that the PBA Young Maintenance Crew tries to do an equitable job with the lanes, and it's evidenced by Jay Robinson being able to play the outside line. He's extremely far out, but most of the players who have scored well this week have played in the track area between the second and third arrow.
Now with the double, leading by 13 as we replay his profile.
Jay Robinson, one of the reasons he's consistent is a short backswing, short push away, and a nice straight swing through the ball. He doesn't hook it too much like he said before, just a straight up lift, very little rotation of the hand.
And now the pro who started his career in the PBA in 1967 will be stroking on the left lane with a double working shooting in the fourth frame.
Stop on a tour of 16 cities. We'll return to Baltimore after this.
Control 6 to base. Looks like this big old hole in the ground is going to be safe for the night, over.
They come out all beat. It's Miller time.
Miller time. Time to appreciate the difference between a good beer...
When it's time to relax...
...and a great beer.
One beer stands clear.
Miller High Life.
You got there the time. We got the beer.
We are very proud of you, Peabody.
Thank you, sir.
Your design of the Firestone 721 is brilliant.
Well...
A tire using 7 around 2 wrapped by 1? Genius.
Oh.
24 million on the road, Peabody. And we're grateful.
Chief, I
just one more thing.
Sure.
Now, Peabody, we want you to top it.
Top it?
The Firestone 721. It's one tough tire to top.
Next, the U.S. battles the Soviets in World Cup wrestling. The amazing spectacle of men and women diving in tandem from incredible heights. Plus, motorcycles studded with spikes racing on ice. ABC's Wide World of Sports is next.
Ah, yes, an exciting day continuing on ABC with Wide World of Sports, World Cup Wrestling, High Diving, and Motorcycles on Ice. Parrish, Merv Parrish, our sixth place finisher, or the alternate.
Really bowled well all week. Should be a contender in the next two tournaments.
Now he needs to double.
Oh, a lovely break. Lovely break. For Mark Fahy of Chicago, cutting Robinson's lead to 13, Bo.
As George Pappas calls it, the messenger shot. The head pin goes to the sideboard, drives through the 4 and the 7, and comes back across the lane and takes out the 10. That's the lively pin action we talked about here at Fairlane's Woodlawn.
Look at the size of this former amateur heavyweight champion.
Three bagger. Now, only three pins separating these two professionals in our first match.
We see the line of Mark Fahy right between the second, third arrow. Watch this ball. Right about the 12th board between in the track area. He gets a great break here. Watch him just push him over the shot we call the Jersey Squasher.
All right. Now Jay back up with that three bagger. He's shooting in the sixth frame. Robinson. The 10 pin on the right lane.
The sharp break of Jay Robinson is hanging that ball right over the channel down to about 45 feet, and it broke very sharply right in. The five-step delivery of Jay Robinson. Watch him slide it to foul line just slightly to his left. And that's what makes him such a good outside shooter as he points that ball, that foot, towards the line he wants to go. He likes that outside line.
Nice cross lane shot that just got the 10 pin. 88 through 4 is spare in the fifth frame of our first match. There you see it. And soon you will see Steve Sipe, Falls Church, Virginia, local professional. Had a great week.
Other than Earl Anthony, this is the only other pro who has won $30,000 on the PBA Tour every year since 1973. Strike in the sixth. And coming right at you.
The trajectory of Jay Robinson. He's playing that outside line, the ball crossing around the fifth board at the arrows, and then way out to even the second or third board, then the sharp break and the good carrying angle at the pocket. Perfect strike.
Mark Fahy, turkey working.
This is action we haven't seen in a number of weeks on the tour. We've had some low scores. In fact, last week we only had a couple of 200 games. But this week, the players have scored really well on this pair. We said at the beginning, and just more of this to come today. Fahy with an 8-pin lead can increase to 18.
No, 1, 2, 4, 10 for Mark Fahy.
Fahy with that powerful body becomes a tendency to become a muscle player. On that particular shot with the short backswing, he tried to throw the ball down with his arm. As a baseball pitcher, you have to use the body and rhythm to make the good stroke.
So for Mark Fahy of Chicago, it is his second open frame. 10-pin lead by Robinson as we'll return.
Better scores.
Fellas, what's in this bag can turn our season around. Watch. The best hook with your ball comes in like so. Not bad. This ball comes into the pocket like this. That's better. Better angle, better carry, higher scores.
Why?
Because this is the world's only urethane ball, and it's called...
The angle.
Remember, if you want to be a winner, you've got to have an angle.
The Angle, available soon at your pro shop.
Want to see the sheathing used in most houses today?
Alfred!
It would take 5 layers of this stuff to equal the insulation value of 1 inch of Thermax by Celotex. No wonder everybody's screaming about their energy bills. For insulating, nothing is more efficient than Thermax by Celotex. For new homes, for re-siding, farm buildings, factories, everywhere.
Alfred, who was that man?
I don't know, but he left this silver Thermax.
Fairlane's at Woodlawn in Maryland. Getting up in that bright red shirt is Jay Robinson. This has been a seesaw battle, our first match live coverage. Robinson now leading by 10 after the lead had been taken away by his opponent, Mark Fahy, the rookie. So now with a strike up, he can increase it to 20, shooting in the seventh frame. The winner to meet Steve Sipe. Then Steve Martin, and then our tournament leader, Wayne Webb. Oh, a high hit and a 4-6 for Jay Robinson. Lights, pressure, we see it a little bit of everything week to week here on the Professional Bowlers Tour telecasts. So from a 10-pin lead, it's at least a 2-pin deficit. So, covering one pin, 127 through the 6, 136 through 7 as we join Bo Burton.
With me is the hometown favorite, Steve Sipe. And Steve, how do you stay so competitive just bowling one tournament a year?
Well, I'll tell you, I just work real hard at home, and when you only get one shot, I just got to make every shot count. And that's all I've been trying to do all week long, is just make every shot count and work the hardest I could.
Okay, Steve, you got 2 more shots at him. You have to win 2 games. Chris, he's going to be out there trying.
Oh, he does look competitive. Here's Robinson. 8th frame. Crossing over, leading the 3-6-10. Jay, who is married to the former Cheryl Kaminsky, one of the nation's top female bowlers. They're the proud parents of one child named Liana. Jay had an average this week of 214, as you see, the 3-6-10. His high game this week was 267. He spent a lot of time growing up with his grandparents, Mike and Marge Wilk of Chicago. I can imagine the thrill they're having watching their grandson compete.
The guy's a great athlete. Spent a lot of time bowling and a lot of time in that boxing ring.
Oh, boy. 6-7-10 for Mark Fahy.
Lack of experience, Chris, showing on Mark Fahy. Here's the powerful style of Mark Fahy. He walks two steps before he even pushes the ball away and then uses that upper body strength to cup it and then generate the speed at the bottom of the swing. Has a really nice finish with a good deep knee bend. But he's in trouble here, the 6-7-10 split.
And the fans here, standing room only crowd, love the effort. 147 through the eighth and a 9-10 lead by Robinson.
Fahy has to compose his thoughts, set up a strike here and be able to close him out in the 10th frame.
It's very little time for sparring profusely here. Another head-on shot.
See the inside line of Mark Fahy. Right around between the second, third arrow, but you've got to remember this left-hand lane hooks more, and he's not giving it enough room. Crosses over for the second time in the match, gets another good break.
Now back to 37-year-old Jay Robinson, Van Nuys, California.
Jay also has been high on his last two shots, the 4-6 in the seventh frame and the 3-6-10 in the eighth.
Strikes in the ninth foundation frame of our first game. The winner to meet Steve Sipe.
With only 9 pins separating the two competitors and both of them having strikes working in the ninth frame, it will be the man who can perform in the 10th frame as almost all our match on the championship round and the televised finals go down to the last ball.
Wanted that one leaving the 10 on the left side.
Jay, the experienced, tough competitor, threw a great shot there in the 10th and unfortunately left a solid 10. That opens the door for a possible tie. If Jay spares and strikes, he'll have 196. Mark Fahy could come up, get a strike, get 9 spare, and we'd have a tie.
Preston. 176 through 9. All this in the first match, and our coverage is live from Baltimore, Maryland.
No matter what Robinson gets on this ball, he is going to force Mark Fahy to throw at least one strike and possibly two to win.
Which, of course, will put the pressure on the rookie. Sportsmanship gesture there, and now, oh, that ball's got to be awfully heavy.
He's in a predicament where he has to throw one strike and 9 spare to tie, or 2 strikes to win. He must have this ball for a strike.
There's one, and Bo has told you what he needs. 9 to tie, all 10 to win.
Gets a great break, the wall shot, using that power he has in his style. Head pin goes to sideboard and drives out to 4-5-7. Now Mark Fahy, with a 9 spare, would have a tie. With a strike, he would defeat Jay Robinson. If he gets 8, he loses.
You got to remember, this is only his 10th career PBA tournament. To this point, he's won 2,195. Dinner bucket will be emptier than he had hoped, but $4,000 nonetheless, because Robinson now will be moving against Steve Sipe in our second game, which will be coming up here on ABC. Pro Bowlers Tour, followed by Wide World of Sports. All right, there it is. A 3-pin victory, Jay Robinson, 196 to 193. Let's pause to hear these messages from our sponsors.
Pro Bowlers Tour, This ABC Sports exclusive is being brought to you by Ford and your local Ford dealer, who invites you to test drive the new 1981 Ford cars and trucks, including Escort, the new world car from Ford. By Celotex, where Thermax insulation is only one of our 10,000 building products. And by Monroe Shock Absorbers, makers of Little Big Shocks. Shocks designed to give today's small cars the right ride.
Coming up next, Jay Robinson versus Steve Sipe. The Pro Bowlers Tour will continue after this message from one of our sponsors and station identification.
There's a company in Toledo, Ohio, who makes an amazing product for your car's engine. It can help improve your car's mileage, give you surer starts, even help your car run better. And the cost of a set is about the same as the price of an oil change. A revolutionary new device? No, it's a fresh Champion spark plug. There is probably nothing that can do so much for your car's engine for so little. Champion, the world's number one seller.
Right guard knows a man needs all the protection he can get. That's why a man needs right guard. Right Guard has a male effectiveness formula so strong, no matter which Right Guard you choose, it helps stop a man's perspiration odor all day long. A man works hard, but Right Guard works harder. Now there's new hard-working Right Guard Solid, too.
All free men and women, join the fight. Masada, starting tomorrow.
Biking's great fun, but it can be risky, too. Every year, cycling causes 40,000 injuries and 1,000 deaths. If you're a cyclist, keep your bike in top condition and fully equipped for safety at night. Two's okay on a bike built for two, but dangerous on a bicycle for one. Most serious and fatal accidents occur on the street and involve an auto. When possible, avoid heavy traffic. Ride in single file. Use hand signals for turns and change of lane, and always obey traffic laws. At busy intersections, you're safer walking your bike across. Be alert for the unexpected. Remember, they may not see you. 41,000 cyclists are injured or killed each year. Take care, and don't become number 41,001. Good counsel from the American College of Surgeons and this station.
KTNV-TV, Las Vegas.
And here on the PBT, Jay Robinson won the first game a mere three pins over Mark Fahy, 196 to 193. Wide World today, World Cup Wrestling, USSR against the United States, mixed pairs high diving, and World Team Motorcycles on ice. Well, it's comfortable on the side here. Outside, it's about 70 degrees in the Baltimore, Maryland area. And here we go with our second match live coverage. Jay Robinson on the left. And it'll be your first chance to see 29-year-old Steve Sipe on the right. A six-footer, a slender Virginian at 170 pounds.
He's sure comfortable around the TV set, Chris, for never being around it before. He's handled himself so great all week long.
Unfortunately, the 1-2-10 on his first shot. He has hundreds of fans here because he's a local professional, Falls Church, Virginia.
We mentioned three factors at the top of the show that could contribute to low scoring on the TV. And number one of them is lack of experience, that pressure of the championship round. It was very evident in Steve Sipe's first ball, the 1-2-10 washout.
But imagine his first tournament here in 1981, on the tour for a while in 1978. So it's an open frame for Steve Sipe. So now here is 37-year-old Jay Robinson. Won the first game against rookie Mark Fahy, 196 to 193. So Nelson, our average on our championship pair to now is 194.5.
Well, that won't take the money today, Chris. I know this pair can yield some higher scores, and I think Jay Robinson, after winning that first match, should make some adjustments, loosen up, and he should have a good game.
Right there. hear you often refer to the track.
Well, the track area is the Warren area on the right side, but Jay Robinson is playing outside and around that track. As we said at the 3 points, that the PBA themselves has their own maintenance crews that maintain these lanes, and they try to put an equitable shot in for everyone, and that means that players can play sometimes out and in at the same time. Jay Robinson has chose the outside line.
Jay had 6 strikes in his victory over Fahy. He opened with a strike here in his second match, shooting in the second frame.
The great benefit of that outside line that we see Jay Robinson playing is a tremendous carry. Jay going right outside the first arrow or the fifth board on the lane and swinging out to almost the second board, breaking that ball back into the pocket, the 16th, 17th, 18th board area, and just blew the rack out. He's open with a double, leads by 21.
All right, Sipe now, after an open, shooting in the second frame. Finished third overall in a field of 192 pros. Just didn't come up, leaving the 2-5. Let's replay that last stroke.
Steve Sipe uses all the approach. He's 6 foot tall, has a 5-step delivery, and it's really pretty ideal. But right now, he's raising up at the line as he comes through the ball and not getting it out. See his body start to raise up before the ball goes by his hip. He doesn't get the leverage and not the finish. He's been light on his first 2 shots.
The long shot here, and being close to Pimlico Racetrack, home of the Preakness, you know darn well that the fans in Baltimore love those long shots.
Well, this is always a great stop on a PBA tour, Chris. Now, we have these two players out here. Sipe is playing what we call the track area, somewhere between the second and third arrow. He's throwing a little straighter shot than Jay Robinson, using the full approach, much like Marshall Holman, but he's trying to roll the ball in the track or Warren area on the right side of the lane.
There you have it. He zeroed in on that pocket. And speaking of Marshall Holman, he finished 152nd.
And here's the shot of Steve Sipe. Watch the trajectory of the ball right between the second and third arrow. That was his best shot of the match, ideally placed right in the pocket.
We mentioned Marshall finishing 152nd, Mark Roth 77th, Earl Anthony 20th. Now, Jay Robinson, a double, shooting now in the third. Three-bagger, Bo.
He's definitely loosened up, especially playing that outside line. You have to be relaxed. Usually a win under his belt like Robinson got in the first match over Mark Fahy is definitely the easiest way to loosen up. Robinson opened to a 31-pin lead, three-bagger working.
Working on that gum.
Seems to be taking a little more time, Chris, than we've seen him in other championship rounds.
Boy, he sets himself carefully on the approach.
Good tip for any player. That's one of the reasons Robinson is so consistent. Very meticulous in his standing position and his spot on the lane.
Oh, he nearly lost that one.
Chris, he slipped on the approach. His right foot slipped out from underneath him on that 5-step delivery right before he came through the shot. When you lose that, now watch as he comes through, he drives off with that right foot. He completely loses the leverage of the swing and almost ditches it. Now, we saw Wayne Webb do that in Kansas City, and he still finished second in the tournament, so it can't be completely disastrous, but it makes it tough.
He glanced over at the monitor to see the replay and brought a big smile. Spare for Jay Robinson. Our second match, he is bowling against Steve Sipe. We'll be back.
You don't have to be a genius to change your own oil and filter and save yourself up to $10. Valvoline Motor Oil shows you exactly how quick and easy it is with step-by-step change instructions on the back of Valvoline cans. It's really quite simple. Once you get the hang of it, just see for yourself, then do for yourself. No wonder more and more drivers are changing their own oil and filters and changing to Valvoline. It's a smart way to save up to 10 bananas without a lot of monkeying around. Right, Val?
Woo,
Okay, we got it. Great shot. You got me.
Come on, Slowpoke. It's Miller time.
When it's time to relax, Miller's got the beer.
Join us next Saturday on ABC as the Pro Bowlers Tour travels to Garden City, New York for the $100,000 Long Island Open. Earl Anthony, off to a sensational start this year, defends his title against bowling's best. The Pro Bowlers Tour next Saturday live at 3:30 Eastern Time, exclusively on ABC.
Yes, we are live from Baltimore, Maryland. 13th stop on a tour of 16 cities, 20th year of the Professional Bowlers Tour telecast. First time ever on our show. 1978, he came out for a seven-week trial, Steve Sipe. Then this is the fifth time he's tried for a Fairlane Open Championship.
This young man has really got to the hearts of the players around here and the fans. He throws a really nice shot there. He's loosened up, rips the five right in into the 4-7, has closed the gap between Robinson and himself to just 18 pins. One more strike would cut it to 8.
His goal, to bowl on the national tour and be accepted as a solid player.
Well, I accept him just by watching
sure.
it, because he really looks...
Oh, there's a perpetual trophy. The 11 champions, one being Nelson Burton last year. Sliding by... 1, 2, 4, 8.
The three bad shots he has rolled in the match so far have all been caused by the same thing, prematurely raising up at the foul line. You have to keep that knee bent down underneath you. If you don't get the leverage. Even if you hit your spot, the ball doesn't finish.
Here's the man that won the first match, Jay Robinson, over rookie Mark Fahy, 196 to 193. Sipe to the line. Sipe gets him. 22 pins separating these two pros. The winner to meet Steve Martin of Kingsport, Tennessee. Then the tournament leader, Wayne Webb.
See if Robinson has made an adjustment in his shoes. We talk about the lanes and balls week to week on the PBA Tour, but the players also carry different pairs of shoes with him, some for slippery approaches and some for sticky. Jay Robinson slipped in that last shot on the left-hand lane. Let's see if he's made an adjustment with his right shoe and maybe make it a little tackier so it doesn't slip.
He opened with a three-bagger, marked with a spare. And, of course, next week we'll head north to Long Island. Long Island, $100,000 open in Garden City. Then to Windsor Locks for the Greater Hartford Open. And then one more on the Winter Tour, the Firestone Tournament of Champions. Then, starting May 23rd, the Professional Bowlers Spring Tour. Five stops and more action live, Bo.
We'll be going all the way to the end of June, Chris. A lot of PBA action on television.
And with that mixer strike, it's a 32-pin lead. Jay Robinson, winner of the first match. And this puts more pressure on Steve Sipe, a non-winner. The spare up shooting in the sixth.
Robinson really showing his experience. He won his first match on experience. So far in this match, he's kept himself, kept the ball in play, kept the ball light from that outside line, and given himself a chance to scramble some light strikes. Has a 32-pin lead, sixth frame.
Steve Sipe, a bachelor who operates a pro shop in Arlington, Virginia.
When he throws them good, they are really good. He just threw that ball solid in the pocket, every pin going right in the pit. But his task right now is to cut into Jay Robinson's lead. If he strikes here, he'll cut the lead from 32 down to 22 through seven frames.
Hit with the 3-6-10.
Well, he's been wide three times and in the pocket three times. That's the first time that he's pulled the ball up into the nose. He avoided the split, but has left the 3-6-10 cross-lane shot.
Steve Sipe's best finish ever. An abbreviated try on the tour was 28th. And it's a disastrous open frame in the seventh, trailing by 44.
I've driven lots of world-class cars.
That is, I've driven, he's ridden.
Here's our latest love, the new Ford Granada.
European grace, American space.
Move. Mileage that would gladden a banker's heart.
Precise rack and pinion steering.
A faced off with a fine regard for the decencies of life.
Granada is more than a pretty face.
I'd rather like a pretty face.
Granada, built with a commitment to quality from the world of Ford.
This is clear, solid Lucite. Tough, durable, made by DuPont to last. Wouldn't it be great if a paint gave you this? Lucite Wall Paint does. The same basic ingredient in solid Lucite is a key ingredient in liquid Lucite. So it's tough, durable, made to wash easily, made to last. Lucite, the long-lasting paint based on a solid idea from DuPont. Now save $3 to $5 or more on Lucite at participating stores.
Jay Robinson had a strike in the seventh frame. Crossover leading the five in the eighth frame with a 53-pin lead. He had strung three, and now he'll be trying to cover a spare as we look at the president of the Women's International Bowling Congress, Alberta Crow. Over 4 million card-carrying members. Their national tournament right here over a total of 55 days in the Baltimore area. Over 600 teams competing, Bo. It's the female equivalent of the men's ABC in Memphis.
You're right, Chris. The Memphis American Bowling Congress tournament is going on in Memphis, and it will be in Baltimore in 1982. So Baltimore is the site of a lot of bowling action. The Pro Bowlers Tour once a year, and ABC and WIBC tournaments.
Great place to visit, Baltimore. Eighth frame. Started with an open, and another one in the fourth, one in the seventh.
Well, to have any chance at all, theoretically, he has to have a strike here. Jay Robinson playing that treacherous outside line, could slip one off in the channel and close the match out, but Sipe, for sure, has to throw a double to keep any type of pressure on Robinson.
Had only one double, that was in the third and fourth. Now a strike up, shooting in the ninth. Second double.
Robinson in the driver's seat coming into the ninth frame. He's going at a 236 pace. The best Sipe can do is 213. Robinson looking at the scoreboard, he's definitely thinking about throwing one too wide and going in the channel. So what he has to do is keep it out of the channel and get just one mark in one of the last two frames. He has moved to the inside line. He's going to go between the second and third arrow, take no chances.
Way to do it. 196 through 8 with a strike in the ninth for Jay Robinson of Van Nuys, California.
We've seen some great pin carry here on the championship here, and the mechanic here took the time out to weigh each pin in of the 40 pins we're using today. Each one weighs exactly 3 pounds, 4.5 ounces, a perfectly matched set of 40 pins.
Comfortable thought needs 8 pins to win. So he gets 9 of the 10 here at the Fair Lanes Woodlawn. We'll give you that final score when it's completed. Right now we're going to take a break to return to Baltimore for the next match.
Before April showers bring May flowers, they bring mud and dirt. So to keep the outdoors out, get this Monsanto polyethylene doormat. Just $2.99 as True Value Hardware Store's April Bargain of the Month. Its tough, weather-resistant bristles clean dirt from shoes, then hose clean easily. And the no-skid backing stays flexible year-round. So keep the outdoors out with this Monsanto doormat, just $2.99 while supplies last, at True Value Hardware stores and home centers displaying this banner.
Working late again, Mr. Peabody?
I'm afraid so, Rose.
You, the genius who designed the Firestone 721 tire.
That's my problem. They want me to top it.
Top it? But isn't the 721 what they call a winner?
Oh, sure. It's got seven around two wrapped by one. There's 24 million on the road, you know.
And you're gonna top that, Mr. P?
Well,
The Firestone 721. It's one tough tire to top.
A lot of folks worry about money, but not me, because I'm not alone. I belong to a credit union.
And I use it. I put money in every month. It's like keeping it in the family, because the members own the credit union.
We pay ourselves high interest. We stand by each other when we need loans.
We can give ourselves a better deal because we're not out to make a profit.
However tough things get, when you're one of us, you're never alone.
America's credit unions. We're a family, 44 million strong.
With eight strikes, Jay Robinson of California defeated Steve Sipe, who shot a 202, 236 to 202, which means that Robinson now will go against another winner named Steve Martin of Kingsport, Tennessee. Speaking of winners, a year ago, the winner of the Fairloins Open was Nelson Burton Jr. We thought it'd be nice for you and for Bo to relive it. Here it is. In last year's Fairlanes Open, Matt Serena held a commanding lead late in the match until missing a 10-pin in the ninth frame. And here in the 10th, he needed a strike. Serena left a 6-7 split, which he failed to convert. This opened the door for Nelson Burton Jr. Bo, what was going through your mind?
Chris, with two frames to go, I thought the match was over. Serena gave me the opening, an opening of a lifetime. I knew I needed just one strike. I tried to throw it as hard, as straight as possible into the pocket.
That was the deciding strike in the 10th frame as Bo edged Serena 200 to 194. That victory marked Bo's 15th career PBA title. Okay, and now we go into the semifinal match. 37-year-old Jay Robinson, winner of two games already in our live coverage. And at 5'6 and powerful from Kingsport, Tennessee, his opponent here will be 22-year-old Steve Martin. Robinson, eight strikes in the last match, six in the first. Qualified number four for today's championship round. And Nelson, having won that last match, he controlled his own destiny, so he doesn't have to worry about being locked out of this year's Firestone Tournament of Champions.
Right, Jay was number three on the list to get knocked out. He cannot get knocked out because all three of the players left today are in the Firestone.
Oh, a 10 pin.
Only the second tap we've seen Jay have so far today. He left a solid 10 in the crucial point in the first game in the 10th frame. Didn't cost him the game. He opens this semifinal match with another solid 10.
Jay's average thus far, 216 on the championship pair after two matches, 206.75. Spare for Jay Robinson. All right, now, an interesting guy. They call him the Tennessee Twister. 5'6", 170 pounds. Been a PBA member 5 years. He's won four titles.
And my pick to really be one of the top players of the decade, Chris.
Leaving the two pin.
This young man, Steve Martin, has all the potential. He's in good physical shape. He's strong, has a powerful ball. And watch how he hits that foul line really low. He's just got the style to dominate the sport, much like Anthony Holman and Roth have done in the previous years.
And his wife, Kim, also from Kingsport, a town of 35,000 people, about 10 miles from Bristol. Ooh, a spare for Martin. We asked Steve earlier what his goals were.
Yes, I was rookie of the year in 77. I've improved every year. I'm going to continue and improve every year and hopefully be on top and be the man to beat in years to come.
And the way he's going and continues to improve, he'll be definitely a contender for the Bowler of the Year every year for a number of years to come.
Steve opened this year's tour, coming from fourth to win the Miller High Life Classic. Occasionally, you'll get a reaction.
Watch this arm swing of this man and the line he's playing. He's playing that inside track line like we said. He just went to the right of the second arrow, lets the ball finish right in the track or worn area of the lane. Gets a good break, two pin, tripping out the four and the seven.
This is our third game in our live coverage. Waiting in the wings, tournament leader, Wayne Webb. It's an impressive stat, 30,000 every year, at least since 73.
Chris, you see a little hole above Jay Robinson's finger holes, and a lot of people ask what that is, and the PBA players call it a mill hole. And what it is a hole put in the ball by the PBA to check to see if the ball's a legal hardness. That's above 75 hardness and has not been tampered with. They feel that sometimes there's an advantage with a softer ball. The players are checked every day on the tour. Now look, just above the finger holes, you'll see that little bitty hole. The amateur bowlers won't have that in their bowling ball.
The 1-2-4-8 for Jay Robinson. Incidentally, today's Rural 8's bowling tip of the week is for the ladies.
And I'm sure with the number of ladies we have here in Baltimore, just alone out here for the telecast, should be able to pick something up. Chris, the one danger of playing outside the track or worn area is that when you cross that area, it's a higher surface friction area and makes spares very difficult. The 1-2-4-8, Jay Robinson figured the ball would not hook quite that much. When he hit that track or worn area between the second and third arrow, the ball jumped, and he left a wide open frame for Steve Martin.
And Steve Martin, the 1980 United States Open champion, jumped right on the opportunity with a double to take a 24-pin lead.
Absolutely awesome, the carry power that players like Martin, Wayne Webb, Roth, Holman get when they hit the 1-3 pocket on today's plastic pins. That ball was not near solid in the pocket, and yet he devastated the rack, opening up a 24-pin lead through just three frames.
Bowlers have an option of wearing a wireless microphone. Steve has one on. Almost crossing over and leaving the 6-9-10.
Throwing that one any worse, old buddy.
No matter how powerful the bowling ball, you must play the lanes properly. Remember, lane 17 hooks more than 18. Martin didn't give it enough room on that shot.
Steve Martin, 22-year-old pro from Kingsport, Tennessee, continues to lead by 21. We'll take a break and then more action.
And all the time I've been hauling new cars, I've never seen anything like it. Quaker State's new Lifetime Engine Lubrication Protection Program. Use Quaker State and you can get protection that guarantees your new car engine against oil-related failure. The engine, as long as you own it, in writing. It's guaranteed by Quaker State. The quality motor oil. Refined from Pennsylvania grade crude oil.
New car or old, you'll be staying on the road with Quaker State.
Better scores.
Fellas, what's in this bag can turn our season around. Watch. The best hook with your ball comes in like so. Not bad. This ball comes into the pocket like this. That's better. Better angle, better carry, higher scores. Why? Because this is the world's only urethane ball, and it's called
The Angle.
Remember, if you want to be a winner, you've got to have an angle.
The Angle, available soon at your pro shop.
Hi, I'm Kurt Gowdy. Join Dallas's JR, Larry Hagman. Tomorrow, as we reel in the 17th season of The American Sportsman, right here on ABC.
Beautiful, exciting show. 17th season, American Sportsman with our friend... Host Kurt Gowdy, Sr. and Jr. is producing this telecast. How about that?
Sports fishing, one of my favorites, Chris. That is really exciting.
All right, Jay Robinson now. He's trailing. Didn't come up. 2-4-5, fourth frame of our semifinal match, the winner to meet Wayne Webb.
He's starting to move away from that extreme outside line that Jay was playing in the first two matches. He moved to about the sixth or seventh board that time to try to get a little straighter trajectory, just overcompensated, hit light, left the 2-4-5.
Ah! Spare in the fourth for Jay Robinson. We're in Baltimore, Maryland, our 13th stop. Tour of 16 cities, 20th year of the Professional Bowlers Tour.
Consistent Jay Robinson trailing by 21. And one of the main reasons that Jay has been so consistent is the roll on his ball. He rolls a spinner shot, much like Dick Weber and Don Carter in their heyday. The ball doesn't break that much, but it's easy to control.
Leaving the 2-8 on the left lane.
Robinson feeling he must take a different angle of attack against an experienced player like Steve Martin, and also trailing by 23 pins, has decided to try to find the inside line that the other players have been using.
Jay Robinson thus far has earned nearly $21,000. Bowling Steve Martin, who is near $36,000 this year.
Much of that coming in the first week as he won the Miller High Life Classic in Anaheim, California.
Come on, make me happy, make me happy. I'm not happy. Yes, I'm happy.
Well, happier than he was with the 10-10 toppling. Make him happy.
We talk about the great pin action, the powerful ball. Watch this. The 5-pin is driven behind the 7. A normal player would drive the 5 in the 7, but power player Steve Martin, 5 went behind the 7, and that's the head pin that came all the way across to avoid the 7-10 split.
All right. Spare in the 5th frame for Steve Martin. They have a pin in the channel. And Jay Robinson very accurately puts the ball down the channel, and out goes the pin.
Steve Martin looking for a re-rack. Naturally, the ball on first ball cycle. All the remaining pins have to be knocked off before he can go for the full set. 42-game format. That's his wife, Kim, who travels with Steve on the tour and helps him quite a bit with his bowling. 42 games this week, Chris. Starting on Monday with the Rabbit Squad, Pro-Am and practice on Tuesday, and the final tournament Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. Wayne Webb taking over in the final round.
Steve leading in the third round. All right, Steve gets his third strike. That one in the 6th frame of our semifinal game, and still with 20-some pins.
Jay Robinson, who is really a tough competitor, has a way of kind of lulling his opponent to sleep. He's kind of making Steve Martin think that he's given up, but I've bowled Jay Robinson many a time. In fact, he's beaten me for one of his titles. That man is out there working hard. He is tough to beat.
That was a strike in the 6th frame. Other money winners this week.
It took a 209 average to get in the top 24. Tommy Hudson bowled sensational. Skip Tucker right up there. Gil Slyker breaking out of his slump. Pete Couture steady. Charlie Tapp. Bob Hanley, one of our champions. And John Handygard, who just got married this week. Bo Bowden, who won in Florida. Jeff Valentine. Alvin Liu, steady as usual. My buddy Dave Sutar. Steve Westberg, lefty up there. Rich Hartman from St. Louis area. Earl Anthony, Billy George, Yip Lentini, the harmonica player, our statistician Palmer Falgren, and Andy Savachian, the top 24.
Leads a double here. Ooh, a high hit.
Ooh. A rather unusual leave. We don't see this very often, the 3-4, 6-7-10. We actually saw a combination of this last week, which Marshall Holman left down in a True Value Classic. He left the 3-4, 6-7 and converted it. So the 10 pin doesn't add any difficulty to the shot.
All right. Asking for quiet now, Frank Esposito. Jay Robinson. Opponent Steve Martin appreciated that effort.
This man's a tough competitor. I told you, look at this, he never gives up.
And I know that's one our director John DeLisa will put in the can and save. Right?
I can never recall seeing that in the last 10 years or so, Chris, and here we had it 2 weeks in a row, converted both weeks.
I haven't seen it in 20 years, Bo. Something. his head. Thought he really had blown that one, but the double with a 32-pin lead now, Steve Martin.
Powerful Steve Martin. All his strikes have been in the light pocket area using that power and good arm swing.
Of Steve Martin. He has a wireless microphone on.
Has a 29-pin lead, but by no means an easy spare. Anytime you have the 2-5 combinations, it's tough, but with a sleeper 8, it makes it twice as difficult.
Robinson is up, trailing by 29. Jay has won two matches already. In his first game, he defeated rookie Mark Fahy of Chicago, 196 to 193. Then against Steve Sipe. He bowled a 236. Sipe had a 202, but now he is trailing.
There's that mill hole we talked about that Jay Robinson has in his ball, but he's not thinking about that. He's thinking about getting some strikes.
In the eighth, 124 through the seventh, whereas his opponent Martin is 153 through seven.
Solid strike, driving all 10 pins off the lane, but it sets up this for Jay Robinson. Right now, Steve Martin is working at a 213 pace. Robinson can strike out for 214. So this is a critical situation here in the ninth to close the gap down to just 19 pins.
Now working with a spare in the eighth frame, here is Steve Martin shooting in the ninth of our semifinal match.
Steve Martin would need a double in the ninth or tenth frame to shut out Robinson. By no means is this match over.
Tremendously professional.
Well, I'll tell you, these players that they have today, the young players such as Steve Martin, Wayne Webb, tremendous talent. For Steve Martin, if he strikes here in the 10th frame, will shut out Jay Robinson. If he doesn't strike, no matter what he does, Robinson can still win the match.
Total field of 192 started. Big 210.
The first big mistake made by Steve Martin. Sent it wide with too much speed. He's looking up. He leaves the 2-8-10. Right now, if he spares and strikes, converts the split, he still can lose the match. But if he doesn't, Robinson would just need one strike to win.
All right. Odds for the professionals, 4-1. Look at that. First a 3-4-6-7-10, and now a 2-10 in Baltimore.
What a sensational shot in a crucial situation. By converting that split, he forces Jay Robinson to throw two more strikes. If he hadn't converted that, Robinson would have just needed one strike.
5'6", 170 pounds.
Kick it, kick it.
High hit and gets it. A 2-13 and six strikes for Steve Martin. Watch this one. One of the reasons why a veteran newspaper man, friend of mine here in Baltimore, Bo, a man named Lou Hatter, who covered baseball for 28 years, has been doing some bowling coverage, and he's fascinated by all you professionals, your attitude about your form of competition.
The pins can go anywhere. The determining strike for Jay Robinson, he must strike on this ball.
7 pin after winning two matches on that shot. Steve Martin, House, Jay Robinson. Martin will go against the tournament leader, Wayne Webb. We'll be back for that match.
Come on, people, one and all. Everyone can use a little armor. All protecting, beautifying, most of all, it's satisfying. Armor All. Once it's sprayed, gets down inside, you'll help things last when it's applied. Come on, people, one and all. Everyone can use a little armor.
What in the blazes is that thing?
This is one of them new small models.
Ride good?
Good, ride's great. Got me some Munro-matic shocks. Little big shocks from Munro.
Little big shocks?
Yep, best ride I ever had.
Of course, them's Munro's.
Darn tootin' Munro little big shocks. Even fits imports.
Yeah, imports. What's imports?
Small car. America rides Munro.
The Space Shuttle Final Countdown, a special assignment next week on ABC's World News.
Gracious living at a gentle price. The Oaks, the finest condominium homes in Las Vegas. Gracious living that includes magnificent living rooms, sparkling contemporary kitchens, luxurious ceramic tiled baths, sauna, pool, and spa. The Oaks, from only $52,000. An incredibly gentle price, $52,000. The Oaks Condominium Homes, West Desert Inn in Arville. Gracious living at a gentle price.
Tuesday night, April 7th, 8 p.m. at the Showboat Hotel and Casino. Mr. T, Tony Trudnish, presents another night of boxing at the boat. See the world champions of tomorrow in action at the Showboat's new 34,000-square-foot sports pavilion. Be there Tuesday night, April 7th at 8 p.m. for another night of top ring action with boxing at the boat.
KTNV-TV, Las Vegas.
A 213 to 190 victory for Steve Martin of Kingsport, Tennessee. So Robinson, after winning two now, has to be content for third, and he will now go against the tournament leader, Wayne Webb. We said the WIBC ladies are here in Baltimore over a 55-day period. Good day to have a tip for the ladies. Here's Nelson Burton Jr.
Bowlers Tour Tip of the Week is brought to you by Rolaids.
Today we have a tip exclusively for you women bowlers. One of the most common mistakes that women make is rolling the backup ball. And today's tip will show you how to correct that problem.
The reason many women roll the backup ball is because of body construction. They do not have the same muscles in their arm as the men, and their tendency of their thumb to move over to the 3 o'clock position and rotate the wrist clockwise.
Now, Greta, in order to correct this, you have to move first to the right side of the lane. Now, this gives you a better angle of the pocket and gives you more strike power. Number two, your hand was open at 3 o'clock. Pretend it's a steering wheel and turn it up to 12 o'clock, because wherever your thumb points, that's the direction the ball will go, and now it should hook into the pocket. Let's see how it works. See, it's not that difficult to correct the backup ball. There are two things you have to remember. Number one, move to the right on the approach. And number two, use that thumb like a steering wheel. Move it to the direction that you want the ball to go.
The New York Stock Exchange. When people here get acid indigestion, and you know they do, they can't just stop. No wonder so many people take Rolaids, the tablet that gives millions 100% relief, like a sponge. Rolaids antacid medicine consumes 100% of the acid required to give millions 100% relief. With Rolaids, you can keep going. Rolaids. Rolaids spells 100% relief.
Now here we go into that final match. 13,000 the winner, 7,500 for the runner-up. And it's sort of a replay of a game last night where Webb defeated Martin 257 to 244. Martin, the victor, won or rather 213 to Jay Robinson's 190. Here's Webb, the tournament leader. First time you've seen him stroke today. Oh, the 7-10 for the man all in green.
And what a bad break. What a way to start out. Watch this. Same shot we saw before. Unfortunately, he leaves both the 7 and 10. Rips the 5 right behind the 7. The 6 lays in the channel. Just a bad break. Normally, they'll carry that shot with that strong ball.
So Wayne Webb of Tucson has an open frame in the first. He is our tournament leader, and it's the fourth appearance for him on our telecast so far this year. Now, Steve Martin, who was in... number two position, ousted Jay Robinson. So here's the big game for him. Right in the pocket.
There's nothing like a win in a championship round to loosen you up. Steve Martin got by Robinson by closing him out in the ninth and tenth frame. And now in the championship match, he's off to an 11-pin lead.
Winner of our very first telecast this year, Miller High Life Classic in Anaheim. And here's a fellow that's always up there. 2 weeks ago, he won three straight, but lost to Marshall Holman, the King Louis. And Tennessean with a double.
Both the players using polyester plastic balls against those plastic pins on a urethane surface this week, just destroying them. You saw the power of Wayne Webb in the first frame. You saw it, Steve Martin, in the second.
So after an open, the pro, Wayne Webb comes back with a strike in the second. Average-sized professionals, both. Wayne Webb is 5'5", 145. And Steve Martin is 5'6", at 170 pounds.
Wayne Webb with a style very similar to the great Harry Tiger Smith. He has that power that he generates at the foul line. He comes up there, he kind of stops short with his left foot and pulls it through with tremendous wrist action in a good tight arm swing.
And last year's player of the year has doubled.
Wayne Webb playing the track or inside line right around the second arrow. The ball being laid on around the third, 13th or 14th board, going out to around the ninth, and just a perfect shot. Bingo.
Double working.
What a shot. Gave that one a lot of room, buddy.
Gave that one a whole lot of room, buddy.
What he means is he missed two or three boards to the left, and as we said, the championship pair, conditioned by the Pro Bowler's maintenance crew, does not give you any pull area. You can give it some room to the right. He pulled it, paid the price, hitting the nose, leaving a split.
3-9-10. Yep. Got the sleeper, but missed the head pin on the spare. So it is 55 through the third for Steve Martin. And instead of an 8-pin lead, he is trailing by 4 here in the championship match.
22-year-old Steve Martin started bowling at the age of 6, so he's got 16 years of experience under his belt. He's only 22.
Good shot. Good shot.
And 8-pin.
Good shot. He knew it when he let go that it was a tremendous shot, his best of the match so far. He left the solid 8. Once again, these crankers are power players, as we see up at the top today. Take advantage of the light pins, but every once in a while they pay the penalty when they drive one pin off the other. That particular shot, the 5 was chopped straight off the 8.
This 22-year-old pro from Kingsport, Tennessee, have a super year, trailing right now. We'll be back.
Nobody beats 27. Nobody beats 27.
Nobody beats 27.
Nobody beats 27.
Ford Courier Confidence.
Nobody
Courier owners know that they have unbeaten estimated MPG of the top-selling compacts.
Nobody beats 27.
27? Nobody beats.
That's Courier's EPA estimate. Use for comparison. Your mileage may vary.
Nobody beats 27. Nobody beats Ford Courier.
Nobody but nobody beats
Ford Courier.
Nobody.
When you buy your family insurance, you're buying more than just coverage. You're paying for service, too. State Farm agents make sure you get that service. If you have a question or a claim, you call us. Life, health, homeowners, or car insurance. When we give you personal service, we're not doing you a favor. We're doing our job.
And like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Personal service. That's what State Farm agents are all about.
An SRO crowd. We're down to the final game at the Fairlanes Open in Baltimore. The tournament leader, Wayne Webb, is going against Steve Martin. Jay Robinson won two matches over Fahy and Sipe and then lost to Martin. Webb, at whom you're looking, leading by four, double working. Ooh, boy. Turning the screws a little bit. A turkey and a 14-pin lead for the tournament leader now.
Wayne Webb, a powerful young player. He's the reigning bowler of the year. He dethroned Mark Roth, who held that crown for three consecutive years. And Wayne Webb and Steve Martin, I think, are the two players to watch in the next 4 or 5 years. They have the ideal style, the confidence, and the power on the ball to be dominant players in this game.
Here's a winner this year. Martin. Webb. Tremendously confident pro, Wayne Webb. And so is Steve Martin. He has a spare up, shooting in the fifth. See the 24-pin difference, that Martin can cut that to 14 if he can strike in the sixth frame. This is a championship match. Down to 14 pins now. That's Kim Martin. Look at that concentration of face, Wayne Webb.
Such a positive attitude this young man has. Comes from a bowling family. His father, his brother Bill, and brother Roy, all three of them have bowled 300 games, including Wayne Webb, four members of that family, 300 sanctioned games.
After an open frame in the first, Wayne Webb, the tournament leader, again leading by 24.
We said this pair of lanes can yield some good scores. We see the experienced players, Robinson, Webb, and Martin, going at it these last couple matches, really picking up the pace.
Wayne had a 300 in the fifth round of play this week. Why the green? Well, he likes leprechauns and the pot of gold. That is the 1, 3, and 9. Smile of disbelief.
Well, these cranker or power players every once in a while cut loose with an errant shot. They're loose players, as we said, and they can throw the strikes to compensate for those wild shots. So Wayne Webb has a task here, actually shooting for the 1, 3, 9, an unusual spare for a right-hander.
A 16-pound bowling ball.
Chris, he converts this easily, and as we wait for Steve Martin to come up, I'd like to congratulate you and Kurt Gowdy Sr. in being inaugurated into the inducted into the Sportscasters Hall of Fame Monday, April 6th. Quite an honor.
Thank you. It'll be fun. Sort of a ABC evening as Al Michaels, our colleague, is the Sportscaster of the Year, joined by Dick Enberg, NBC.
Right now we have two players who might be in a pivotal match for Player of the Year, the defending Player of the Year. Wayne Webb leads in the match by 22. Steve Martin, who's already won one championship this year, in the championship round.
So it's a spare for Kingsport's Tennessean Steve Martin, seventh frame. 22 pins separating these two, 13 to the winner, 7,500 to the runner-up. To the seventh, strike in the eighth.
Super shot by Steve Martin, holding the ball right in the pocket. Both players using about the same ball speed, Chris. We find the winning speed on the Pro Tour around 18 miles an hour for the interested spectator, and Wayne Webb has kept it right in that area for the first seven frames.
Who strung five, then marked with a spare, gets a strike in the eighth frame. Don't forget, following our telecast, 5 Eastern, 4 Central and Pacific, Wide World of Sports, the United States versus the USSR in World Cup Wrestling, the World Invitational Mixed Pairs High Diving Championship, and the World Team Motorcycles on Ice Championship.
Wayne Webb coming up in the crucial ninth. Leads by 22, can increase that lead to 32 with one more strike.
Two-pin lead now, coming right down to the final shots of this championship match in Baltimore.
Look at that arm swing, that lift, the wrist action right between the second, third arrow. High revolution on the ball. Bingo. Has definitely put the pressure on Steve Martin. A must situation.
A double for Steve Martin.
Steve Martin needs a strike on this ball to force Wayne Webb to mark in the 10th. As you can see, Webb going at a 236 pace, Steve Martin at a 214 pace with a possible 234. Must strike on this ball to have any chance of winning the match.
Three-bagger, and Kim is happy. Lead cut down to 12 now.
With one more strike, Chris, he can cut that lead to 2 pins. It'll go down to the final ball, much like last year in this tournament. Martin, a possible 234. Webb going at a 236 pace. He's already forced. Martin has forced Webb to at least mark.
Performance by both professionals, 22-year-old Steve Martin and 23-year-old Wayne Webb.
Martin going to his great fort, the power ball, drives the five right into the 4-7, has a possible 234, has got the pressure on Wayne Webb.
Six, seven, a 231 for Steve Martin, who defeated Jay Robinson to get into this final match. Appreciated by the crowd. Now they're standing for him. 5-10 lead held by Wayne Webb. What a match.
Chris, Wayne Webb has not missed striking on the right-hand lane. He's struck in the second, fourth, sixth, and eight frames. Needs a 16 fill in the 10th and 11th to win. Must mark.
On the right lane.
And his power saved him on that shot. An average player, even on the Pro Tour, with a line ball and not the power shot, would have left the 2-4-5. They were standing there for a moment. Wayne Webb drove him out. He needs this spare and a 6 count to win the match.
All right. Got that one. 215 through 9. the tournament leader. 2 weeks ago, he won three straight matches before losing in the title match to Marshall Holman in the King Louis Open. But today, he was the tournament leader. He needs seven. Just sit and watch. Hold a 231.
By one pin, 232 to 231. We'll be back. Wayne Webb, 232. Martin, 231.
There's got to be a way to top the 721.
George Peabody, go to sleep.
Look, I designed Firestone's tire using 7 around 2 wrapped by 1. There are 24 million on the road. Still, I ought to be able to top it, right?
Right.
Of course, it'll take time. Nights, some weekends, maybe months, years, a lifetime.
Maybe never.
What? Did you say never?
Never.
Never?